Hello everyone, I am Divya, your math facilitator. As a part of our essay 1 revision, today let us discuss statistics chapter. Okay, so before getting into the topic, let me tell you, in this particular session we are going to revise the concept of the entire chapter, as well as we shall discuss a very important previous year questions which you can expect this year also. Okay, so before that, let me also give you the weightage of this chapter. Okay, so I have been getting many messages like to tell the important chapters, important questions. Let me tell you, these videos are to tell you important chapters and important questions only. Okay, so the statistics is very important chapter for you, so that is the reason I'm discussing it with you. Okay, so understand, it's a very important chapter. I'll tell you the weightage also, so that you can understand more clearly how important it is. And also, I'll tell you the important questions from the chapter. So once you learn these questions, you can be very confident that same model questions you can expect in your examination. Okay, same model question. So in order to solve the same model question, I'm also explaining you the concept. Okay, so that you can solve the same model question on your own. Clear? So important questions are covered in this session. Okay, so let me tell you the weightage of this chapter. So firstly, you will get one essay question. You have very short answer type, short answer type, and essay questions, isn't it? So very short answer type, I'm expecting one or two questions. Okay, you can have one or two very short and one or two short questions from this chapter, and two essay questions you will have from this chapter. Okay, if you see the previous year papers, SA1 papers, previous year, at least past 4 years papers, if you see, every time you get two essay questions from statistics chapter. Okay, so every time two essay questions, so this time also you will get two essay questions. So which means each essay question carries 8 marks, so you'll have each essay question carries 4 marks. So 4 2s are 8 marks you can score here. Okay, and short and very short, so you can get one or two very short and one or two short. So if you get one short, it will be 1 mark or 2 mark. 1 or 2 mark here you will gain, and very short is 2 marks each. So if you get 1 or 2 short, then 2 or 4 marks you will gain. Did you understand? So 1 short if you get, you will get 1 mark. If 2 short they will give you, very short, you will get 2 mark. If 1 short they are giving you, you will get 2 mark. If it is 2 very short in the question paper, you will get 4 mark. And also part B, objective, you will definitely get 1 or 2 questions again. Okay, so on an average I'm taking 1 mark for this. Okay, so if you just count the weightage, count the marks, so 8, let me take the minimum marks. So 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 8 11 plus 1 12 marks you will score. Okay, if you take the maximum marks, 2 plus 4 6 6 plus 8, so 14 14 plus 1 15, so 12 to 15 marks you will score from this chapter. Okay, minimum 12 marks, maximum 15 marks you will score from this chapter out of 40 marks. So out of 40 marks, if you are able to score 12 to 15 marks, it is a huge, huge weighted chapter. Now, did you understand how important this chapter is? So I'm expecting all of you to be with me for the entire session, because we are going to discuss the concept, we are going to discuss the questions. So same model questions you can expect in your examination. Only if you know the concept you can apply it, right? So I'm discussing the entire chapter within a very short time. So stay tuned till the end of the session and do like the session right now. Okay, so as I told you, the weightage is 12 to 15 marks. So let's proceed now. So I want you all to maintain a book and write all these so that you can revise it just one day before your examination. Okay, so suppose I have conducted a class test. Okay, so there is a class test which is conducted. Okay, and I conducted the test for say 10 students. The number of students is 10. Okay, so I conducted the test for 10 students. Right, and the total marks for which I conducted the test is, say I conducted the test for 10 marks, right? So now I just want to list out the score of the marks. I just want to list out the marks gained by each of my students. How many students are there? there are 10 students. So if I list out the marks, let me write the marks as one student got say 8 marks, one student got, let me take the marks as 20. So at least you will have little variety of marks. One student got 8 marks, one student got 10, 11, 15, 14, 11, 10, 8, 8, 9, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 marks I have written here. These are the marks of 10 students. Okay, these are the marks of 10 students. No one got above 15. So let us write one above 15. Okay, so let me write this as 19. At least one student, let them get above 15, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 students got this course, okay? So now, if I want to, calculate some data, if I want to draw some conclusions from this data, if I want to see how are my students performing, if I want to come to some conclusion, then I will need some tools to come to some conclusion, to analyze this data. Okay, so what are those tools? Those tools are called as mean, median and mode. Okay, the tools which we use for the conclusion are called mean, median and mode. Now suppose if anyone asks me what is the average mark of your students, what is the average score of your students, so what will I do? I will calculate mean. Okay, mean is nothing but the average of the observations. I can say these are my observations, right? This is what my students scored, these are my observations. So the average of the observations, if I want, how will I calculate mean? Mean of any given data is nothing but sum of observations divided by number of observations. Mean of any data is sum of the given observations divided by number of observations. Clear? So what you will do is you will just add all the data. So 8 plus 10 plus 11 plus 15 plus 14 plus 11 plus 19 plus 8 plus 8 plus 9 whole divided by number of observations is 10. Since you have 10 students, you are taking 10 observations, isn't it? So the final answer will give you the mean of the data. Mean is nothing but if anyone is asking me what is the average mark of your students, then this is the average mark. I'll say on an average my students scored this mark. Okay, now suppose, tell me this answer in the comment box right now. Okay, now suppose if anyone asks me what is the median mark of your students. Median mark means the middle value. Okay, median. What is median? It's nothing but middle. Okay, the in between value. So what do I do in order to find the median mark? I'll just write the given data either in ascending order or the descending order. Only then I'll know the middle value. Okay, if it is a random order, you will not know the middle value, right? So only when we arrange it in some order, you can pick out the exact middle value of that particular range of data. Okay, so here it is just raw data. So if you want the middle value, firstly we need to arrange them in ascending or descending order. Usually I prefer ascending order. So ascending order, let us take the values. The smallest value is 8, isn't it? So again you have one more 8 here and one more 8 here. So 3 8s I have. Let me cancel out the 8s I have written. So I wrote this 8, this is also done, this is also done. So these 3 8s I wrote. Now I have 9. So let me write 9 here. Then I have 10 here. Okay, so let me write 10. Then I have 2 11s, 1 and 2. Okay, how many times the number is repeating you have to write. Okay, and in order. After 11 you have what? You have 14 and then 15. And then you have 19. So just count the data. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So all the 10 values I wrote it now. Okay. Now you want the median value. So if anyone is asking me what is the middle value, what is the median of your class mark. Then after arranging it in this order, you will just pick out the middle value. Now here you can see, since you have 10 students, now picking out the middle value is little difficult. How? See, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Now if I take 5 and 5, there is no middle value. Okay, so actually there are two numbers which are in between, isn't it? Now for example, if my data is something like this, if you have your data something like this, if there are only 9 students, okay, if there are only 9 students, okay, I'm just ignoring the last value. If there are only 9 students and if I want the middle value, okay, so what will you do? 1 from this side, 1 from this side, 2 from this side, 2 from this side, 3 from this side, 3 from this side, 4 from this side, 4 from this side, and this is the middle value, isn't it? So directly you can actually take 4 numbers on the left side, 4 numbers on the right side. If you remove, this will be the middle value, isn't it? So this is the single value you got, and this you can say the median of this particular data is 10. 10 is nothing but which observation? This is the first observation, second observation, third, fourth, fifth observation. Okay, it is the fifth observation, or I can say it is the fifth value. Okay, the fifth value is the median. Then the value of the fifth observation is 10. Okay, now here, since you have two middle values here, since the number of terms, the number of observations are odd. Okay, whenever they are odd, you can remove 4 from this side and 4 from this side, and you got the middle number. Suppose if I have only 3 numbers, 3, 5, 7. If I want the middle value, it is nothing but 5. One number from this side you are removing, one number from this side, easily you are getting the middle number. When is this happening? When the number of terms are odd. See here, 1, 2, 3. 3 is an odd number. Okay, you have only 3 terms, which is odd. So when the number of terms are odd, you can happily pick out your middle value without any confusion. But when the number of terms are even, here you can see how many terms are there. I am representing it by n. How many terms are there? 10 terms are there. Here how many terms were there? You have 9 terms here. Okay, so this is 10 terms. So since it is an even number, you are getting 2 middle values. Okay, if you are removing 4 from this side, 4 from this side also, you are having 2 middle values. So in this case, what you will do is the median you will take it as the average of the two middle values. Okay, so 10 plus 11 is 21/2, which is 10.5. And always observe, whatever median answer you are getting, the average is, it lies between the two values which you are taking. Okay, so whenever there is a single value, you are directly taking it as a median. And when will this happen? When the number of terms are odd. When the number of terms are even, what happens is you will have two middle values. So what you will do is, since median is a single value, you cannot take two values. So I am taking the average of these two values. Average is nothing but adding these two and dividing by two. Since you have only two numbers, if you want the average of two numbers, you will add the two numbers and divide by two. Okay, we have learned what is mean or average. It is sum of observations divided by number of observations. Here there are two observations. You will add these two and divide by how many observations? Number of observations is 2. So you will add and divide by 2. You will get the average of these two. Okay, average is 10.5. So this 10.5 lies in between these two. So that is a check you can do. Always the median which you are getting, that will lie between the two values you have taken. Okay. So till here, is it clear? Okay, so suppose if I give you one more question. 8, 9, I'm writing it in order. 11, 14, 15. So how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you want the middle value, you can happily remove 2 from this side and 2 from this side, and this is the middle value. Okay, this 11 is the median. Suppose if there are more terms, suppose if there are 9, 8, 9, 11, 14, 15, 16. So here how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 terms, which means even number of terms. So even if you remove 2 from this side and 2 from this side, these two will be your middle value. So you, what will you do? You will take the average of these two. So 11 plus 14, which is 25/2, you will get it as 12.5. Now this 12.5 lies between these two values which you have taken. So median is 12.5. Did you all understand now how to find the median? Now for the median only we have a formula. Okay, so I have told you n is nothing but the number of terms, isn't it? And n is number of terms. So when n is odd, directly you can pick out the middle value. When n is even, you are actually taking the two values and taking the average of them. Till here, is it very clear? Now I'll tell you the formula. That is the reason. If this is, all these examples are clear, okay? Now the formula is, here you see, I told you this is nothing but the fifth observation. The median, how are you getting? It is the fifth observation, isn't it? So this fifth observation, can I write it as 9 plus 1 by 2? 5. Fifth observation is nothing but 5, isn't it? This 5, can I write as 9 plus 1 by 2? It is 10 by 2. 10 by 2 is 5, isn't it? 10 by 2 is 5. So this 10 only I have written as 9 plus 1. Why did I take 9? 9 is nothing but my n, isn't it? So you can always write the formula as n plus 1 by 2. Okay, now I'll give you the formula. Median of the number, here you got it as 10.5. okay, the median of a number when n is odd, n is nothing but the number of terms. If it is odd, then median will be n plus 1 by 2. Okay, n plus 1 by 2 observation. Okay, n plus 1 by 2 is nothing but the number of observation. Now here in this case, n plus 1 by 2 is 9 plus 1 by 2, 10 by 2. That is fifth observation. So you will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fifth observation. So this is the median. Clear? So when n is odd, directly you will take n plus 1 by 2. You know, odd numbers we represent in this way. Even numbers as 2 into something. Odd numbers is 2 in 2x plus 1. So instead of 2x plus 1, I am taking it as n plus 1. So odd number, always you will have a plus 1. Okay, so you can remember that way. If it is odd number, it will be n plus 1 by 2. Since it is median, you will be taking the in between value, half of the value. So divided by 2 you will do. Clear? Odd number is always you will add 1 to that number to get a odd number. Okay, so you are adding 1 to get a odd number. You can remember it this way. I am just telling you that to help you to remember. Okay, 2x is even, 2x plus 1 will be odd. Okay, instead of 2x you have like n, right? So always plus 1 will give you odd number. Okay, so whenever it is odd, you will take n plus 1 divided by 2. Why you divided by 2? Since you want median value, in between value, half of the value, so you'll divide by 2. Okay, so this is when n is odd. Now what if n is even? See here, when n is even, what is this observation you have taken? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have taken 5th observation and this is 6th observation. You have taken 5th observation and 6th observation and you divided by 2, isn't it? We have taken 5th observation and 6th observation. We added it and divided it by 2. This is what we have done. So 5th observation is nothing but this 5, I can write it as n by 2. Since n is 10, so 5 directly I can write as n by 2 plus 6, I can write it as 10, 5 by 2 plus 1. Okay, see here, 5 I can write it as 10 by 2. Okay, now if I add 1 to this, will I get 6 here? Okay, to this 10 by 2 only, if I add 1, that is 5 plus 1, again I'll get 6. So 5 I am writing it as n by 2. Okay, that is 10 by 2. And 6 I will write it as 10 by 2 plus 1, that is n by 2 plus 1, whole divided by 2. This will give you a median. That is what we have done. Manam chesinde numbers lo, I am denoting it in variables. Ardhamainda? So first I told you examples, the same examples nunchi I am deriving the formula for you. Okay, so that you will understand better. So now if I want to say what is the median when n is even, what are we doing? You are taking n by 2 observation. Okay, n by 2 observation and the next observation you are taking. Next observation, if you add 1 to this, you will get the next observation. Okay, you are taking n by 2 observation. Half of the value these put in first. N by 2 is nothing but the fifth position, fifth observation. And the next observation is nothing but sixth. Sixth, how will you get 5 plus 1? If you do, you'll get 6. So n by 2 is the half of the value you are taking and the next value. Now you'll take the average of these two to get the, isn't it? We are taking the average of these two to get the median. Median will be in between these two values. Clear everyone? Did you all understand? So when n is odd, you will have n plus 1 by second observation is nothing but the median. When n is even, you will take the average of these two, n by 2 comma n by 2 plus 1. Plus 1 until the next observation you are taking. Okay? So when n is odd, as I told you, you will directly take plus 1. This is 2x ni n ankunte n plus 1 by 2 observation you will take. When n is even, 2x n ankunanga direct n divided by 2. Okay? This is n plus 1 divided by 2. Right? When n is even, it is n by 2. When n is odd, this is the thing. It is n plus 1 by 2. Remember this. And when n is even, you are having two middle values. So n by 2, okay, the next value is plus 1, you will add to it. I hope it is very clear now. And if you want, let's do it in this example also. 8, 9, 11, 14, 15. There are 5 terms. So n is 5. So it is odd. Whenever it is odd, it is n plus 1 by 2 observation. Odd ante plus 1 minus. That is equal to 5 plus 1 is 6 by 2. That is third observation. So 1, 2, third observation. This is your median. Understood. Now here n is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is even. So when it is even, you will take n by 2 observation. 6 by 2 is 3. 3 next 4th is counted. 4th is nothing but n by 2 plus 1. 3 plus 1 is 4. So third and fourth observation you have to take. 1, 2, 3 and 4. These two observations mean you will take. Clear. Now let's proceed to mode. I'll just erase this now. Let's proceed to mode. Now what is mode? Mode is nothing but the most repeated value. Most repeated. Median is the mean value. Sorry. Median is the middle value. Median is the middle value, mediator, middle value. Mean is the average. Okay? Median is the middle value. Middle value ekkada untadi madhyalo half lo untadi ga, so always you are dividing by 2. Clear? Mean is the average. Average means you will calculate all of them. So sum of all observations divided by total number of observations. Median is only the, you are concentrating on the middle value. So arrange it in ascending or descending order and you are concentrating on the middle values. So you are dividing by 2 to get the middle value. Mode is the most repeated value. Now what is the most repeated value? See the data. From the data, if I want the most repeated value, see 8 is repeating 1, 2, 3 times. 10 is repeating only 1 time. 11 is repeating 2 times. Isn't it? So 8 is the most repeated value. 8 is the most repeated value. This is the mode. Clear till here everyone? So mean, median, mode is clear. And there is one more last concept called range. Range of the data is nothing but whenever this data is given to you, just choose the highest value and lowest value. What is the highest value and what is the lowest value? Choose the highest and lowest value. Highest is 19, lowest is 8. So range, if anyone asks me what is the range of marks of your students, range enta, okay, what is the variety? So you will say it is 19 minus 9, highest value minus the lowest value, which gives you 10. So the range of data, that is the variation of the data, is 10. Okay, so highest minus lowest value, subtract this, you will get your range. Actually, it is 8, right? Is this very clear? So mean, median, mode and range. And this is for a data given to you in this way, which is not at all grouped. Okay, there is no group, there is no frequency in it. Now let us try to arrange this data in some order. Okay, if na class marks CV. From the class marks, I found what is my mean, what is my median, what is my mode, what is my range. Till here, is it clear? So when one data is given to you, you will be able to find four things from the data. You will be able to find mean, you will be able to find median, mode and also range. Okay. In question paper also, if any data is given to you, if they are asking you mean, median, mode or range, this is how you can find. Okay. So let's proceed to the next concept. Okay, now suppose if I want to see, if I want to see how many students scored 8 marks, how many students scored 9 marks, how many students scored 10 marks, okay, I want to see how many of them are scoring a particular number of marks, okay, so nothing but I want to know the marks and I want to know the number of students, okay, the number of students who are scoring these particular marks, right, so now the marks are starting from 8, I have a 8 mark, I have a 9 mark, I have 10, I have 11 and 14, 15 and 19, okay, these are the marks which my student got. So how many students got 8 marks? 1, 2, 3 students got 8 marks, so I am writing 3. How many students got 9 marks? Only one student got 9 marks. How many students got 10 marks? Only one student got 10 marks. How many students got 11 marks? 1 and 2 students got 11 marks. How many students got 14 marks? Only one student. How many students got 15 marks? Only one student. How many got 19? Only one student. Okay. So if I take the total number of students, just count and see 3 plus 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the total number of students were 10. Total number of students are 10. So did I get my total number of students? So what did we do basically here? So I just counted how many students got each of these marks. Okay, this is the data. So I was just counting how many students are getting these marks, which is nothing but I am seeing how frequently these marks are scored by my students. What is the meaning of frequency? Frequency is nothing but how many times something is happening. So if I say how frequently do you eat dosa in your breakfast, what do you see? So you will just count how many times I am eating dosa in my breakfast and that is the number you will give. Okay, how frequently do you go to watch movie? So you will count the number of times, isn't it? So here also I am counting the number of students. Always remember, whenever you see this word number of, it is nothing but they are giving you the frequency. Clear? Okay, so this is called frequency column. Okay, this is called column. This is frequency column. Whenever you see number of students, this is frequency column. And this is the data given to you. Okay, so I am seeing that 3 students scored 8 marks. 9 marks is scored by only one student. 10 marks is scored by only one student. 11 marks is scored by 2 students. Okay, so this is the data. Now this data is called as frequency distribution. What is it called as? It is called as frequency distribution. See, it is frequency. You distributed the data in the form of frequencies. So it is called as frequency distribution. Is it very clear to you? Okay, so this is the from the given data I have written frequency distribution. Now again I have a doubt. Acha, I have written this. Okay, so 3 students got 8 marks, 1 student got 9 marks, 1 student got 10 marks. This is the data I have. Now again I thought to conduct special classes. Okay, special classes to those students who are not, you know, working good, and I want to see how are my students basically performing. So what I'll do is I'll group my students according to their marks. So I'll see 0 to 10. All the students who scored 0 to 10 marks, I'm grouping it as making one group. Okay, so I'll think that this is the group of, let me say average students. Okay, and then 11 to 15 marks. Okay, so 0 to 10 I have taken. So let me take it as 10 to 20. Again, single interval it will be. So let me take it as 0 to 5. 5 marks I'll group. I'll make a group. Okay, 6 to 10. And 11 to 15. 16 to 20. What did I do? 5 marks I made a group. Okay, 0 marks to 5 marks is one group. 6 marks to 10 marks is second group. 11 marks to 15 marks is next group. And 16 to 20. So 5 marks is a division of a group. Okay, so these groups are called class interval. Okay, I have divided my students into different classes depending on the marks. Okay, and this is called as class interval. So whatever you have written here, these are called as class intervals. Okay, now I want to see how many students are a part of each of these classes. Okay, so firstly 0 to 5 marks. How many students scored 0 to 5 marks? There are no students who got between 0 to 5. So there are no students. How many students scored 6 to 10 marks? 6 to 10 marks. See, 8 marks, 1, 2, 3 and 9 mark 1, so 4 students. So how do you write this data? We use tally marks to write the data, okay, to count. Since it is only 10 students, you can easily count. But if there are 50 students, then you will confuse, isn't it? So that is the reason we use tally marks here. Okay, what is tally mark? So whenever you count, whenever you feel a particular data is of this group, you will write a vertical line. Okay, so let us do it now. So 1, this 8 belongs here. And this 10 also belongs to this group. So 2. And this 8 belongs here, so 3. This 8 also belongs here, 4. And this 9 also belongs here. So for the 5th line, we just strike it off in this way. Okay, you write 4 vertical lines, and for the 5th line, you just strike it off. You write a slant line. Why are we doing this? Suppose if there are 10 students, 10 people belonging to a group. So if you just count and draw these lines in this way, later whenever again you want the number, again you have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The best method is, suppose if I draw 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, and the 5th line, instead of drawing it in this way, what I'm doing is I'm just striking it off in this way. And again 6th, I will start from here, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10th line I'll strike. Again 1, 2, 3, 4. 5th line again I'll strike. So here, see, counting these lines is easy, or counting this is easy. This is a set of 5, set of 5, set of 5. So I can easily, by just looking at it, I can say 5, 10, 15. 5 table, you can see the multiple of 5. 5, 10, 15. Clear? So just for our convenience, we are doing this way. Okay, now now when you save your money in kiddy bank, when you want to count your money, what do? The easiest method is, what you do when you have so much of money, so much of coins in your kiddy bank, what do? You just keep all the coins, 5 coins or 10 coins together, isn't it? And then you count, finally you say this is 10 rupees, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So instead of counting each and every rupee, you just make them groups and then count them easily. So here also we are making a group of 5, 5, 5. To identify, we are writing 4 lines, and 5th line we are striking off. So this is one group, this is one group. So 5, 10, 15, you can count it this way. The only reason we are doing is just for our convenience. Okay, so to save time and energy. So I have 5th line here, I striked it off. Now next, 11 to 15. I have 11 here, 115. So 111, 115. 114 also comes to this group. One more 11 I have. That's it. 16 to 20, only 119 I have. Okay, so now let us write the frequency. Frequency is nothing but number of students in this particular group, isn't it? So how many students are there in this group? No students, so 0 student. Here, 5 students. You don't have to count. Just seeing this, you can say 5 students. How many students are there here? 4 students. How many are there here? 1 student. So just count the total number of students again. 5 plus 4, 9 plus 1, 10. So again 10 students you got. So the number of students are same. Clear? So the same data, I wrote it as a frequency distribution, distributing it in form of frequencies. And again I have distributed in the form of groups. Now this is called grouped distribution. Grouped frequency distribution, or grouped distribution you can say. Why? Because I'm distributing the data in groups. And how you can distribute? You can choose your class interval. You can take any class interval depending on the question given to you, and you will write the tally marks. Okay, you'll just take the data and you'll write the tally marks here. And how to write the tally marks? You'll write 4 vertical lines, and if you have the 5th data, strike it. And if you have the 6th data, again you'll start from here. Okay, and then finally what you'll do, the 3rd column is frequency column. You will count how many marks are there, okay, how many tally points are there, and you will write the frequency here. And the total number should always match with the total number of data you have taken. Okay, this is what we have learnt now. Now, there is one more very important point, let me tell you. So, now I have written, these are the class intervals, isn't it? I told you, these are called class intervals. The grouping which you are doing here is called class interval. Okay, so in every class interval there are 2 values, isn't it? One lower value, one higher value. One lower value, one higher value. So this lower value is called lower limit, and the higher value is called upper limit. Okay, so the first value or the lower value we call it as lower limit, and the next value you call it as upper limit. clear? So you have a lower limit and you have a upper limit, okay? And also the next point is, each of the class has a size. Size is nothing but I can say strength of the class, okay? Number of, if I ask you what is the size of your class, that is nothing but the strength of your class. You will say how many students are there in your class, isn't it? So here in this case, how many values can this class accommodate? How many values can it take? From 0 to 5 values it will take. So how many values, what can I say, the size of the class, class size, or you can also call the class length. Class size or class length is nothing but you can take it as upper limit minus the lower limit. Okay, the upper value minus the lower value will always give you the class size. Okay, so 10 to 6, how many values you can have? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5 values. Class size is 5. 11 to 15, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 5 values. Okay, so class size is 5 in this case. Clear? And next, let us proceed to the next concept. Okay, so I have this. Now suppose the same class, if I want to write it in this form, let me write it here. Okay, the same class interval. Now I want to group it differently. Let me take the tally mark and let me take the frequency. Okay, I want to group it differently. So how will I group it differently? See here, I have taken 0 to 5, 6 to 10, 11 to 15, 16 to 20. So these are called discrete. Now this group is called, the name of this type of class interval is called discrete. Okay, it is called discrete or inclusive class interval. I'll tell you why are we giving these names, don't worry. Okay, inclusive or also you can say discontinuous class interval. Now the class interval which I'm going to write is called exclusive class interval, or you can also call as continuous class interval. I'll tell you why are we calling this and what is the difference between both of them. I'll tell you. So the class intervals, now I am thinking to write it as 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20. You can see there is a continuation here. 0 to 5, again you have 5 here. 5 to 10, again you have 10 here. 10 to 15, again you have this 15 here, 15 to 20. Whereas if you see here, it is 0 to 5. After 5, you jump to the next number. You have 6 now. 6 to 10. After 10, you jump to the next number, which is 11. 11 to 15. After 15, the next number is 16. 16 to 20. But here, 0 to 5, again you have 5. 5 to 10, again 10 to 15, 15 to 20. So I can say these are continuous. There is no break here. 0 to 5, again 5 is continuing. Again 10 is continuing, again 15 is continuing. There is no break here. These are continuous. So that is the reason we call them as continuous class interval. Here there is a break. 0 to 5, there is a break. Then you are starting with 6. 6 to 10, there is a break. 11 to 15, break. Again 16 you are starting. So that is the reason they are called discrete or discontinuous class intervals. Okay. Now the next point is, whenever you have continuous class intervals in this way, so now the question comes, where do you write the values? Okay, so I'll just start writing the values and then I'll explain you. Okay, so first 0 to 5, as we know there is no data for 0 to 5. So there are 0 tally marks, 0 data. 5 to 10, let me erase this. 5 to 10, so how many 5 to 10 values you have? How many 5 to 10 values you have? Just see here. 5 to 10. I have 8. 8 is in between 5 to 10. So I'll write 10. Now 10. Should I write 10 here or here? Here also I have 10. Here also I have 10. Where should I write? Should I write 10 here in the second class interval or in the third class interval? That is the question. Here there was only 1 10. So you included here. Here there is 11. Okay, so you included in this class. But here there are 2 class intervals which have 10. So where should we write? So in order to avoid confusion, the general rule we follow is, we always take, if you get this value, this upper limit value, this is upper limit, isn't it? This is lower limit, upper limit. This upper limit value, if you get that, you will take it in the next class. When it is exclusive or continuous classes, you have the same value you have. See, so instead of taking it here, you take it here in the next class. Okay, so you will not consider the upper limits. These upper limits are not considered. Okay, you will take it in the next class. clear. So in other words, I can say I am taking only till 9 values here. Only till number 9. Only till 9 marks I'll take it here. The 10th mark I'll not write here. I'll write here. Here also only till 14 marks I'll take. 15th mark I should write here in the next class, not here. Did you all understand? So that is a general rule. Okay, why ma'am? Just to follow a same rule. Okay, so for example, the rule is we all walk on footpath, isn't it? That is a general rule. If we don't follow that rule, if everyone is doing as they wish, then you can see there are a lot of accidents happening. So in order to avoid confusion, So no one will know where are the people walking, where should the vehicles go, right? So we are following a general rule, we walk on the footpath, okay? We cross at the zebra crossing, general rule. Since we are human beings, we follow few rules in order to avoid confusions and disturbances, okay? So here also, we are following a simple rule, okay? All of us have thought of one rule and we are following it. What is that rule? Instead of writing here, you will take it in the next class. For which value? Only for the last value. Clear? Here 10 is your class in upper limit. So I'll, instead of writing here, you will write here. Okay, now 11, where will you write? 11 is here. 10 to 15, 11. Now 15, see, 15, will you write here or here? Here or here? You will take in the next class. Here you will not include. Next class you will include. Now 14 will come here. 11 it will again come here. 19 will come here. 8 will come here. 5 to 10. 8 again will come here. 9 will come here. Okay. So just take the frequency. So there is nothing here. So 0. There are 4 values here. 4 values here. 2 values here. If you count the number, 4 plus 4 plus 2 is 10. Again, the total number of students you got. Clear? So the same given data, if you observe, the same given data, I wrote it as frequency distribution table, distributed in frequency. Again, I made these marks into groups, okay? And this is called grouped frequency distribution. Again, in these groups also, I can make two types of groups. One group is with class intervals, inclusive class interval. One is with exclusive class interval. Now I told you, I'll tell you the meaning of this. Discrete or discontinuous, you understood. Since they are not continuing, these are called discontinuous. Since they are continuing here, they are called continuous. Now what about exclusive and inclusive? See here, the meaning of exclusive is, exclusive means you are excluding. Okay, what are you excluding? The upper limit here you are excluding. You are not taking the upper limit here. You are taking in the next class. Okay, here also you will not take the upper limit value. You will not take it in that particular class. You will take it in the next class, which is the lower limit. Okay, 10 ikkada vachindante ikkada iskoru lower limit lo consider chesaru, ee class lo consider chesaru, which means this last value we are excluding. The last value you will not consider, you are excluding. Okay, so 10 to 14 only you will consider here. 15th value you will actually write here, right? 5 to 9 only you will consider. This 10th value you will actually write here, which means you are excluding the last value. That is the reason they are called exclusive. Inclusive means, see here, whatever values you have, 0 to 5, you will include in this class only. You will not go to next class. Whatever values 0 to 5 you have, you will write here. Whatever 6 to 10 you have, you will write here only. You will include here only. So that is the reason they are called inclusive. Now I hope you will understand very clearly. Now no confusion, isn't it? So class intervals, you can always divide it into two types. One is inclusive and there is exclusive. Inclusive is also called as discrete, or you can call it as continuous, discontinuous class interval. Inclusive is called as continuous class interval. Okay, and all the rules also I told you. Okay, so with this we completed all the required concepts. Now let us proceed to finding mean median mode. Let us find mean median mode when this frequency distribution is given to you. Okay, whenever this distribution is given to you, let us find mean median mode of the given data. And when class intervals are given to you will find the mean median mode in class 10. 10th class lo nechukuntaru how to find mean median mode when class intervals are given to you. As of now, you will find mean median mode for this frequency distribution when this is given to you. Okay, and this is given to you when itlanti data ichinappudu we already found mean median mode range, isn't it? Now for this data, let us find. Okay, and one more important thing, I covered every point here. Okay, so inclusive, exclusive, lower limit, upper limit, class length, class size, tally mark, frequency. So they will also ask you write the groups. okay, here in this class they will ask you write the class intervals, okay, with class size as 10. So you have to take the class size as 10. Here the class size is 5, so you will take it as 10. 10 means 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30 you can take, and you can write the tally marks and you'll write the frequency. So they will ask you to make a grouped frequency distribution with class size as 10. So what are the three columns you will take? Class mark, tally, frequency. Okay, class mark, tally, frequency. Now the question is, madam, itla raayala, itla raayala, your wish. Okay, depending on the question you will write. I hope the concept is very clear. Whatever you write, these marks will differ. See, the same data, the number of students is same, 10 and 10. But here, since it is discrete, you got 0, 5, 4, 1. Since it is exclusive class interval, this 10 we are including in the next class. So the frequency is changing, but the total number will be same. Okay, so whichever way we do, that is just a representation of the given data. Clear? So let's proceed to the next concept, finding mean, median, mode of these frequencies. So essay questions, this is an essay question. When a data is given to you, this is only for 10 students I have taken, they may give you for 50 students, 40 students, and they will ask you to prepare the table. We shall do problems on that, and they will give you these type of tables and they will ask you to find mean, median, mode. So these are two essay questions which you can expect. Let's proceed to the next question now. So okay, let us proceed. So what did we take the mean of the data? For this particular data we found mean, isn't it? What was the mean of this data? Let me write it here. So total marks, here we found the mean of this data. What is the mean of the data? Sum of observations divided by number of observations. Sum of observations is 8 plus 10 plus 11 plus 15 plus 14 plus 11 plus 19 plus 8 plus 8 plus 9. Isn't it divided by 10? How much was the answer? Did you find? First question was this, first concept which we discussed. So 8 plus 8 plus 8 is 24 24 plus 10 is 34. 34, 11 plus 9 is 20. So 34 plus 20 is 54. And 19 plus 11 is 30. So 54 plus 30 is 84. And you have 15 and 19. 15 plus 19 is, 15 and 14. 15 and 14 is how much? 29. So 84 plus 29. 13 113. So 113 divided by 10, you will get it as 11.3. Did you get the same answer, beta? Okay, so mean I got it as 11.3. And what was the median for this? Median how much did we get? 10.5, isn't it? Median we got as 10.5. And what was the mode for this data? We got 8, the most repeated value. Okay, so the same data I wrote it in this form, and when we had it in this form, these are the mean, median, mode values we got. Okay, so why am I writing? I'll compare and show you. So now the same data I wrote it in frequency distribution table form. Now I want to find mean of this. How do I find mean? So always remember, whenever you have number of students, this is nothing but frequency. Number of and a word is a frequency, you represent it by fi. Okay, and these, whatever data is given to you, you represent it by xi. Here in this case it is marks, you represent it by xi. Number of students is frequency. Number of is frequency. Okay, how frequently, how many are there is frequency. So you denote it by fi. Fi and aim, first the f1, f2, first frequency f1, second frequency f2, f3. So 1, 2, 3 kaakunda fi and simply represent sm. Here also first observation, second observation, third observation, you simply represent as xi. x1, x2, x3 and nankana xi. Okay, general ga. Now what do you do is, you take the product of fi, xi. To find the mean, these are the two columns which will be given to you in the question. Okay, the third column you write is, you will take fi xi. Okay, you will write fi xi. Fi xi is nothing but product of these two. Okay, just multiply these two and write 8 3s are 24, 9 1s are 9, 0 into 1 is it 0? It is 10, this is 11, 10 into 1 is 10. 11 into 2 is 22, 14 into 1 is 14, 15 into 1 is 15, 19 into 1 is 19. Now what you will do is you will add all these observations. Add all these observations, how much are you getting? 13, 13 plus 2 15, 15 plus 4 19, 19 plus 5 24, 24 plus 9 33, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 1, 1, 3. Okay, if you are adding all these observations, you got 113. Now, this is nothing but adding all the observations is nothing but summing sum. If you add all, if you add something and if you get the answer, okay, that is called as sum. Okay, and this sum we represent it with a Greek letter called sigma. This is called sigma. It is like inverted ulta V. Ulta E. Okay, so this is called summation. Whenever you are adding something, you can represent this, okay, the answer with this summation. This is called summation, or this is the name of this letter is sigma. It's a Greek letter. Okay, so summation of, now summation of what you are doing, what are you adding? You are adding these FIXI. Okay, this is FIXI column. What is FIXI column? It is nothing but you are multiplying FI and XI. Okay, so I wrote the name of the column as FIXI, nothing but FI into XI. You are doing FI into XI here. Okay, FI into XI. Now, what am I doing? I am adding all these FIXIs. This plus this plus this plus this plus this. So, it is nothing but I am summation of FIXI. Okay, this is called as adding all the FIXIs is called as summation of FIXI. And the sum you got is 113. Now also, this is the sum. 10 is the sum of all the frequencies. So you will write it as summation of. Sum is called as summation of frequency. You are denoting by FI. So summation of FI is 10. Now if you want mean of this data, mean of the data, you will write it as summation of FIXI divided by summation of FI. Okay. I'll relate this with the previous mean and I'll tell you. Summation of FIXI is 113 divided by summation of FI is 10. Summation of FI is nothing but the number of students. Okay, you know mean is sum of observations divided by number of observation. This sigma FI is nothing but number of observations, number of students is 10. Okay, so this is clear for you. These two are same. Okay, number of observations, sigma FI is 10, both are same. Now this is 113. How did you get this 113? In just now I have done. So the numerator here sum was 113 divided by 10. The same thing you got, right? So it is 11.3. See, the mean is the same you are getting. Whether you do in this way, sum divided by number, or in this way. The only difference is you have written frequency distribution here. Okay. So if I want the total sum, this sum is nothing but the total sum of all the observations. So if I want the total sum of all the observation, 8 is repeated 3 times. So I have to multiply 8 3 times to get the total sum of 8 marks. Okay, now we are adding all these to get the total sum. Clear? So rendu same edo veru veru gaadu rendu same ila chesina meeku mean ila chesina same vachindi ila chesina same vachindi ila chesthe enti ante meer 8 ila rasaru 8 plus 8 plus 8 you wrote it this way and you are adding it 3 times. Adding 3 times anna 24 vastadi, multiplying 8 into 3 anna 24 e vastadi kada, right? And then you are adding with the next observation, rendu same ardhamainda enduku multiply chestunnam, adding 3 times or multiplying 3 times. Multiplying it by 3 is the same, right? So you are multiplying it, you are getting the sum. So in this way you are getting sum of all the observations and you are adding all this so that you will get the sum of all the observations. Did you all understand this now? So both are actually the same. Okay, you will get the same answer. Okay, so the only step to find mean of the given data, you will take the data and you will take FIXI, take the product of FI and XI, and you will take the summation of FIXI. Sigma is nothing but summation of FIXI, and this is summation of frequency. And the formula is sum of observations divided by number of observations. Sum of all the observations is this, sigma FIXI divided by number of observations is sigma FI. కొత్తది ఏం కాదు, సేమ్ థింగ్, అందుకే మీకు కనెక్ట్ చేస్తున్నాం. క్లియర్? సో మీన్ వీ గాట్ ద సేమ్ ఆన్సర్. ఐ హోప్ ఇట్ ఈస్ క్లియర్. నౌ ఫర్ ద సేమ్ డేటా లెట్ అస్ ఫైండ్ ద మీడియన్. మీడియన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ వాట్? మీడియన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ద మిడిల్ వాల్యూ. isn't it? Median is a middle value. Now here, what did you do? You arranged it in ascending or descending order and you found the middle value. But here, how will you find the middle value? మనకు తెలియదు అది 8 3 times వచ్చిందంటున్నా, 9 1 time వచ్చిందంటున్నా, 10 1 time వచ్చిందంటున్నా, కానీ ఎగ్జాక్ట్గా మిడిల్ వాల్యూ ఏంటి మనకు తెలియదు. సో వాట్ యూ విల్ డూ ఇస్ యూ విల్ ఫైండ్ క్యూములేటివ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఫర్ ఫైండింగ్ మీడియన్. ద కాలమ్ యూ విల్ డ్రా ఇస్ దీస్ టూ ఆర్ గివెన్ ఇన్ ద క్వశ్చన్. ద నెక్స్ట్ కాలమ్ యూ విల్ డ్రా ఇస్ క్యూములేటివ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ. నౌ వాట్ ఇస్ క్యూములేటివ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ? ఇన్ యువర్ రిపోర్ట్ కార్డ్ ఆల్సో యూ హ్యావ్ CGPA, cumulative grade point percentage, isn't it? So CGPA is nothing but cumulative of all the grade points. Okay, in each subject how much grade you are getting, you are accumulating, that means you are adding. Cumulative is nothing but adding all the grade points, you will get the final cumulative grade point, isn't it? CGPA. So here also cumulative frequency, cumulative of whom? Cumulative means adding all whom will you add? Frequencies. Where are frequencies? Here are frequencies. So adding all these frequencies, you will get this column. Okay, so I'll explain you more. Okay, so firstly let us find this column and I'll explain you more. So first value you will write as it is. For the second value you will add this value also, the next value, the next frequency value also you will add. So 3 plus 1, you will get 4. For the next value again you will add the next value here, so 4 plus 1, you'll get 5. Now again 5 to 5, you will add 2, so you'll get 7. Again to 7, you will add 1, so you will get 8. Again to 8, do add 1, you will get 9. Again to 9, you will add 1, you will get 10. So what are we doing? You are taking the sum of all the frequencies. And to check whether your cumulative frequency is correct or wrong, this last value which you are getting, this should be equal to the total number of observations or the total frequency. Okay, you need to match a value. Then whatever you have done is correct. Okay, these additions are correct. Now I'll explain you what is the meaning of this. See, 8 and 3, the meaning one tells you, which means 3 students got 8 marks, 1 student got 9 marks, 1 student got 10 marks, 2 student got 11 marks, 1 student got 14 marks, 1 student got 15 marks, 1 student got 19 marks. This is the meaning of these two columns. Now what is the meaning of this column then? 3 students got 8 marks. The first point is same. 3 students got 8 marks. 4 students got up to 9 mark. See the difference. 4 student got up to 9 mark. Up to 9 mark ante 8 kuda indlo kalipi untadi. Okay, together with 8 and 9. Up to 9 means from 0 to 9. There are 4 students who got from 0 to 9. 5 students got up to 10 marks. So who all got 10 marks? Levandi ante. So there are 5 students. 8 mark student will stand up, 9 mark student will stand up, 10 mark student will stand up. So there are 5 students. Okay, who got 8 marks? Only 3 students will stand up. Who got 9 mark? Only 1 student will stand up. Who got 10 mark? Only 1 student will stand up. Who got up to 10 mark? So 5 students will stand up. So this is the meaning of that. Who got up to 15 mark? Where is 15 mark? Here it is. Who got 15 marks? 1 student will stand up. Who got up to 15 mark? Everyone who got up to 15 mark stand up. So how many students will stand? 9 students will stand. So 9 students got up to 15 mark. Okay, did you understand the meaning of this now? Okay, and clear. So this you are getting the total number now. Okay, which means idine nika rastanu chudandi. So 8 marks 3 students got. Okay, and 4 students got. So 1 student got 9 mark. And ikkada varaku any students ayindi? 1 2 3 4. Ee number daniki ardham. And then 1 student got 10. Okay, so ikkada varaku enna ayindi? 5 students ayindi. Ikkada varaku 2 student got 11 marks. So ikkada varaku 6 7 students ayindi. Okay, and 1 student got 14 marks. So ikkadiki 8th student. 1 student got 15 marks. So ikkadiki 9th student. 1 student got 19 marks. Ikkadiki 10th student. Did you understand this? Ee chinna data got nenu meeku malli raasi chupichanu. You may have bigger data also. Only 10 students, so you are able to write. And then you can find the median. But when it is bigger data, median enti ee renditi average 10.5 vachindi kada. Now when it is bigger data, now you understood, right? So enduku idi kanukunnam, idi teliyaneka meeku a student idi 11 mark a student ku vachindi, 7th student ki 11 mark vachindi. One second. So idi 9 10 11 11 14 15 19. So itla rasinappudu 7th student got
11 mark, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this 7th student, till 7th student, there is 11 mark. Okay, 5th student got 10 mark. Are you understanding? The column importance are there. You will know which student got which mark. Okay, 5th student got 10 marks, 7th student got 11 marks. Next date ane got it? 11 iddar kochin amada, 6th, 7th iddar kochin. 8th student got 14 mark. 9th student got 15 mark. 10th student got 19 mark. Did you understand? So, itla meeku order ochindi. In order to write median, you need it in an order. So, you got the order. Isn't it? So, instead of writing in this way, malli ichina data and malli itla rase badlu, we are finding the cumulative frequency. So, this cumulative frequency is helping us to find which the position of students. Do you all understand now? Okay, why are we writing cumulative frequency? Clear? And now if you want to find the median is nothing but, median is nothing but the middle value, isn't it? Here, number of students, nothing but n value. Sigma fi anna, n anna same. Number of students are how many? 10. Okay, so n is nothing but 10. Is 10 even number or odd number? Even number. When 10 is even number, what did we thought of doing? You will take n by 2. Okay, you will take n by 2 and n by 2 plus 1. N by 2 ante 10 by 2 ante 5th observation and n by 2 plus 1 ante 6th observation. Okay, 5th and 6th. So here clearly you can see 5th observation ante between 5th and 6th you want. Median lies between 5th and 6th observation here. Between 5th and 6th. So what you will do is you don't have any 6th. So between 5 and 6 you want. So you will just go with the next observation, which is the 7th observation. This one. This rendit maddilo di kavali manaki. Ante kada apade kada manaku 10.5 vastundi. Right? So what we are doing is we are just going by the next wala observation. Okay, the next highest observation, 5th, 6th kavali. So you can actually take the difference of these two. Okay, 10 plus 11 by 2 anna iskochu leda directly you can go with the next higher value. Okay, we have written this table. Okay, instead of taking 5th and 6th, you want 5th and 6th, so I am taking the next highest value, which is 7th. So 7th observation ki corresponding value is 11, so you can say 11 is the median. Okay, approximately you can say 11 is the median. Since it is a very less data, manaki ikkada koncham difference ochindi median, but when the data is huge, so I'll show you examples also, you will get the accurate answer, don't worry. So process aithe ardhamaindi kada. So you are taking just the value, okay, n by 2 and n by 2 plus 1, 5th and 6th. So you will take the next higher value, which is 7th. 5th, 6th, rendu all got a 7th iskuntaru. Okay, if it is exactly 5th observation, you directly go 5th observation ikkada directly undi kada. So just go, 10 will be the median. Clear till here? So that is about median. Now one more very important point in terms of median, I'll tell you. Just see here. Now the cumulative frequency which you have written here is called less than cumulative frequency. Okay, less than cumulative frequency. Enduku? So here the thing is, if I say how many of you got less than 11 marks, less than 11 marks ante enta mandi kochindi, 5 students got less than 11 marks. So that is how you can count. Okay, so that is the reason it is called less than cumulative frequency. In that class example cheppanu kada, how many of you got till 9 marks ante 4 members. So less than 10 marks ante 4 members. Clear? So this is called less than cumulative frequency. Suppose if I want to write greater than cumulative frequency, so let me take number of students here, that nothing but frequency. Let me write greater than cumulative frequency. They may ask you in question, write less than cumulative frequency and greater than cumulative frequency. Less than cumulative frequency and itla rastaru, but greater ante itla rastaru. So frequency is 3 1 1 2 1 1 1. So if you want, total is 10, isn't it? If you want greater than cumulative frequency, you will start from here, highest ever kochindi. Okay, greater than means you will start from the highest value. So write 1. Now to this one, I add the next higher value. So 1 plus 1, 2. To this 2, add this, you will get 3. To this 3, add this, you will get 5. To this 5, add this, you will get 6. To this 6, add this, you will get 7. To 7, add 3, you will get 10. Again, the check is this total number and this last value should be same. Okay, less than ante em ledhu, first nunchi start chesnam, chinna dan nunchi start chesnam, adding okokati add cheskunte velthanam last cost. Greater than is you start from bottom and you go up. okay, this is you come in this order, this is you go in this order, pike elthundru, clear? So it is less than and greater than. Now we shall solve few previous year questions and then wind up. So this, with this we completed all the concepts. Acha, we have mode. Mode is nothing to do with mode. So this is the frequency we have. ఇది టేబుల్ ఇస్తారు మీకు. వాట్ ఈస్ మోడ్? మోడ్ ఈస్ ద హైయెస్ట్ రిపీటింగ్ వాల్యూ, ఇస్ కాల్డ్ మోడ్. ఇస్ ఇన్ ఇట్ హైయెస్ట్ రిపీటింగ్ వాల్యూ. హియర్ యూ కెన్ డైరెక్ట్లీ సీ ఎవరు ఎక్కువ రిపీట్ అవుతున్నారు. 8 ఈజ్ రిపీటింగ్ మోర్ టైమ్స్. 3 స్టూడెంట్స్ గాట్ 8 మార్క్స్. సో డైరెక్ట్లీ యూ కెన్ జస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ యూ విల్ చెక్ విచ్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ హైయెస్ట్. Okay, which frequency is highest, so that will be your mode. Okay, since this is the highest, 3 1 2 2 2, so the highest kabatti mode is 8. Clear? So directly mode ki meer em cheyalsina avasaram undi, directly just ichina table lo unchi highest frequency edun chudandi idi kada. So this is mode, the corresponding value is mode. Clear? So let's do a few previous year important questions now. Okay, so this is a previous year very important question given to you. Have a look at the question. The marks obtained in S1 exam out of 80 marks of 50 students. So these are marks out of 80 of how many students? 50 students. Okay, are given. Construct frequency distribution table of class interval as 10. So you need to construct frequency distribution table with class interval as 10. So you want class interval. So I told you, what is the next column? You'll have tally mark, and the last column is frequency, frequency distribution table. Okay, so class interval, tally mark, frequency. So what is the class length they want? Class interval as 10. So you want 10-10, class size should be 10-10. So whenever a table is given to you, this is actually a table given to you. So what you will do is, you will consider the lowest value. So from the table, just check what is the lowest value. So lowest value, please check, and what is the highest value. If you just see, 7 is the lowest value and 78 is the highest value. 7 is lowest and 78 is highest. Okay, so if I want to construct a class interval as 10-10, and total marks are how many, beta? Total marks are 80. That means, can I group them as 10-10? So 0 to 10 students as one group. Okay, and 11 to 20 students, 20 mark student as one group, 21 mark to 30 mark student as one group. So I can group it, isn't it? 10 marks as one group. Okay, so and the class interval is 10 size as they asked you, isn't it? So what are we doing? 0 to 10 10 mark student is one group, 11 mark to 20 mark is one group, 21 mark to 30 mark is one group. Next 31 to 40, next 41 to 50, 51 to 60, 61 to 70, 71 to 80. All the students who scored 71 to 80 will be in this group. Clear? So now let us write the tally mark. So this is nothing but taking class interval. So once this is done, we will write the tally mark. So now see here, 0 to 10. Okay, there are two methods to do. First method is, seeing the class interval, you will check where are 0 to 10 marks and you will write the tally mark here. Second method is directly 41. Where is 41? Here you have. So directly you will write. You will go in this order. 41 you will cut here, you will write 1 here. 72 you will cut here. Where is 72? 72 will come here. Okay. These are two methods. Whichever is easy for you, you can follow that. So 49. Where is 49? 49 will come here. Next 38. Where is 38? 38 will come here. 68 will come here. Okay, next to 44, where will 44 come? Here. Next 27 will come here. 46 will come here in this group, 41 to 50. 35 will come here. 43 will come in this group, but already 4 are completed, so 5th you will do this way. Okay, next 12 will come here. Okay, 59 will come where? Here. Okay, so you should be a little careful while you are writing the tally marks. 49 will come here. 5 is completed, so again new line you will write. 29 will come here. 45 will come here. 13 will come here, 11 to 20. 48 will come in this row only. Again 19 will come here. 40 will come here. 47 here. Okay, and 46 here only. So 4 is completed. Now 5th line you will write in this way. 8 will come here. 43, where is 43? 43 will come here only. So okay, now 39 will come here in this line, in this mark, class interval. 50 will come here. 18 will come here. 37, where is 37? Here you will get, so 5th line. Okay, 78 will come here in the last one. 38, where is 38? It will come here. 5 is completed, so next new line you will write. 46 will come here. Okay, since I explained you all the concept, now it will be easy for you to do. 37 will come here in this 31 to 40. 48 will come here, 41 to 50 lo 48. 24 here, 21 to 30 lo 24. 48 again it will come here, so 5th line. 7 will come here. 45 will come here. Aipoyindi again new line starts. 49 will again come here only. 23 will come here. 25 will come here only, 5th line. 49 will come here, 41 to 50 low. 28 will come here. 61 to 70 low, sorry. 41 you will get it here in 41 to 50 only. 32 in 31 to 40. 40, 26 will come here, 21 to 30. 48 again here only you have, so 5th line. 36 you will have it here, 31 to 40 low, so 5th line. 42 again you will have it here only. 58 you will have it here. So if you see, the maximum people are here in 41 to 50 marks. So the frequency, okay, so the frequency, I am taking it this way. Table me neat ga giyandi exam lo. Okay, table you should draw it very neatly. So give little space for tally marks and draw, since I don't have place here. So frequency itlo untadi. Okay, give little space and draw. So frequency is nothing but how many students are there. Only 2 students, you'll just count the tally mark. How many are there? 4. How many are there? 5 plus 2, 7. This is 5. This is 5. 5 plus 1 more 5. So 10. 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. 5 4s are 20 plus 1, 21. This is 2. This is 2 and this is 2. Now count the total number of students. 5 plus 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 7. 13 plus 10, 23, 23 plus 21, 44 plus 2, 46 plus 2, 48 plus 2, 50. So to check whether you have done it correctly or not, once you write the frequencies, the total number should match. Okay, this total number should match with the number of students. Then your answer is 100% correct. Okay, so this you will get it for a essay question, compulsory essay question. This and mean or median you will get for another essay question. Okay, so I hope this is very clear for you. So they will give you the table, you will write the class interval, and then just counting, be little careful when you are counting and writing. Follow an order, random ga cut cheyakandi, you will make mistakes. Follow an order and write. Okay, have little patience, follow order and write. And this last value should match with this. Clear? So let's proceed to the next question now. Okay, the next question, this is also a previous year question. So students of some school contributed as a donation. Okay, this amount as donation. You need to find the mean of contribution. Okay, so class is given to you, number of students contribution. You don't have to do anything with the class. Idu urke ichar me confuse cheyadaniki, so you can actually delete this. And I told you number of, whenever you see this word number of, it means what? It means number of means frequency, isn't it? So frequency ikkada ivvakunda meeku ikkada icharu to confuse you again. Okay, so whenever you have number of, it is frequency. So this summation of all the frequency will give you what? It will give you the total number of students. Total number of students is not given to you. So if you add only, you will get the total number of students. Okay? So chala mandi em chestarante second column ga frequency id add chestaru, this is the total number of students antaru. No, this is the contribution they are giving. Okay, how many 5 rupee coins, how many 10 rupee, how many 20 rupees. So that is what it is. Number of students is this. So this is frequency. Okay, so if you want, we can rewrite the table. Okay, that is the question. Now for the answer, what will you do? You will write contribution first. Contribution is nothing but your xi, and you will write your frequency. Frequency is nothing but number of students, that is fi. Contribution is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Number of students is 110. Okay, number of students is 110, 92, 112, 186. This means 110 students donated 5 rupees each. 92 students donated 10 rupees. 112 students donated 15 rupees each. And okokkalu 15 rupees ichchalu. Enta mandi icharu? 112 students. This is the meaning. Now what we will do? The next column I told you to find mean, what will you do? Mean is nothing but sum of observations divided by number of observations. Number of observations you will get it by adding all this. That is number of students here in this case. So just add the frequency 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6, 10. So 2 plus 9, so 10, 11, 12 plus 8, 20. Again 3, 4, 5. So there are total how many students? 500 students. Okay, so your number of students are 500. Now you want fi xi, the total amount given by all the students, sum of the amount etlosari. Just multiply these two. Okay, multiply fi xi. The third column is multiplying these two. Okay, why are we multiplying? If you multiply 110 into 5, you will get the total amount of 5 rupees. If you multiply 92 into 10, you will get the total amount of 10 rupees. Suppose example low, suppose there are 4 students who gave 5 rupees. So total amount enti ichara vallu 25, 4 is 20. If there are 2 students who gave 10 rupees, so total amount, total 10 rupees is 20 rupees they gave. Okay, total 10 rupees amount ento chhi 20, total 5 rupees ento chhi 20. So just multiplying the number of students with the amount they gave, you will get the total amount. Now if you want the total amount donated by all these 4 plus 2, 6 students, so you will get it by adding these two. Similarly here also, multiplying you will get the amount of 5 rupees, multiplying you will get the amount of 10 rupees, multiplying you will get the amount of 15 rupees. Adding all this, you will get the total amount given by the 500 students. Clear? So let us multiply. This is 550, this is 920, 92 into 10, 15 into 112. Let's do it. 6521108611680. And 20 into 100 is 2000. 25 into 86. So $2150 I'm getting, isn't it? If there is any calculation mistake also, please ignore. Okay, right? So ఉండదు, మ్యాక్సిమం ఒకవేళ ఉంటే ఇగ్నోర్ చేయండి, రైట్? బికాస్ ఐఎమ్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్ వెరీ ఫాస్ట్. సో 0000, సో 5 ప్లస్ 2 7, 7 ప్లస్ ఇది 10, 10 ప్లస్ 5 15 ప్లస్ 1 సారీ ప్లస్ 5 10, 10 ప్లస్ 5 ప్లస్ 5 అంటే 20. నా అగైన్ దిస్ ఇస్ 9, 9 ప్లస్ 6 ఇస్ 15, 15 ప్లస్ 5 20, 20 ప్లస్ 2 22, అండ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ 1 హియర్. సో 22 ప్లస్ 1 ఇస్ 23. Now 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so mean is nothing but, what is mean? Let me write it here. Mean is nothing but sigma fi di, fi xi, isn't it? This last summation, whatever you got, sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi. Already concept manam discuss chesam. So 7300 divided by 500. So 0, 0, 0, 0 cancel. 73 divided by 5. 5 1s are 5, you'll have 2 here, 5 4s are 20, point you'll have 3, so 14.6. So on an average, mean and tendi, on an average, each student, you can see they donated 14.6 rupees. On an average, if you take, they donated 14.6 rupees. Okay, so this is how you can find the mean. This is a essay question. The only column you will write is ఫస్ట్ అర్థం చేసుకోండి, నంబర్ ఆఫ్ స్టూడెంట్స్ అంటే దిస్ ఇస్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ, ఇది ఎఫ్ఐ, సిగ్మా ఎఫ్ఐ అవుతుంది, ఓకే, నాట్ దిస్. సో యూ కెన్ రైట్ అండ్ దెన్ యూ విల్ జస్ట్ టేక్ ద ప్రోడక్ట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ టూ, ప్రోడక్ట్ ప్రోడక్ట్ ప్రోడక్ట్, యాడ్ ఆల్ ద ప్రోడక్ట్స్ అండ్ దెన్ డివైడ్ దిస్ బిగ్గర్ ప్రోడక్ట్, దిస్ బిగ్గర్ సమ్మేషన్ డివైడెడ్ బై టోటల్ సిగ్మా ఎఫ్ఐ. క్లియర్? Okay, the next question is the weight of boys and girls are given to you. You need to find the median weight. Median weight ante median anagane manam em ankovali, cumulative frequency. Okay, so here two columns are given to you. Weight boys, weight girls iskovali. Okay, so they want median weights. They gave you two questions. Okay, weight and boys is actually one. So you will find, if you take weight and boys, you will find median weight of boys. Then again you will take weight and girls, you will find median weight of girls. Okay, సో రెండు కలిపి ఇచ్చారు మీకు. వెయిట్ బాయ్స్ ఇఫ్ ఐ టేక్, సో దిస్ ఇస్ వెయిట్ ఇస్ 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55. బాయ్స్ ఇస్ 3, 4, 8, 5, 5, 3, 2. దిస్ మీన్స్ దట్ దెర్ ఆర్ 3 బాయ్స్ విత్ 25 కేజెస్, 4 బాయ్స్ విత్ 30 కేజెస్ వెయిట్, 8 బాయ్స్ హూజ్ వెయిట్ ఇస్ 35 కేజెస్. ఓకే, so now I need to find cumulative frequency. Always whenever you have to find median, remember you should find cumulative frequency. So cumulative frequency ante less than a find out chestam, usually less than a find out chestam, okela question lo greater than adugute greater than find out chestam. So 3 you will write first, then 3 + 4 = 7, 7 + 8 = 15, 15 + 5 = 20, 20 + 5 = 25, 25 + 3 = 28, 28 + 2 = 30. Okay, so how will you know whether this is correct or wrong? Add all the boys, number of boys. This is nothing but frequency hai kada. So adding all this you should get 30. So 7, 7 + 8 = 15, 15 + 5 = 20, 20 + 5 = 25, 28 = 30. So both are matching, so your answer is correct. Now n is even, it is even, so you will find n by 2. So 30 by 2 is 15, 15th observation. Where is 15th observation? Okay, so directly 15th observation and then n by 2 plus 1. So 15th kaadu, manaki rendittu madhyalo kavali median, right, not 15th one. So n by 2, since n is even, ikkada rastam. It is an even, so even means you need the average of these two observations. So n by 2 is nothing but 16th observation. So you need the average of 15th and 16th observation. So there is no 16 here. So what you will do is you will go for the next higher value. Okay, so 20th cumulative frequency, the value is 40. So the median weight of boys is 40. Did you all understand? Now similarly, let us take for girls. Okay, for girls, let me take weight of girls and girls cumulative frequency. Only three columns. Weight is 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55. And girls 2, 3, 8, 9, 7, 4, 1. Count the total number of girls. 5, 5 + 8, 10, 13, 13 plus this is 110, this is 10, 20, 30, 34. Total 34 girls are there. Count and check. So if you want the cumulative frequencies, it is 2. 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 plus 8 is 13. 13 plus 9 is 22. Isn't it? 13 plus 9, 22, 22 plus 7, 29, 29 plus 3, 33, 33 plus 1, 34. It is matching, so cumulative frequency correct. Ipudu em cheyali, n by 2 value iskovali, ikkada n entha 34, so 34 by 2 ante you will get 17. Okay, and n by 2 plus 1 value you will take. Why are we taking two values? Because n is even. So 17 plus 1 ante 18. 17th and 18th observation. You don't have 17 and 18 here. You have 22. The next higher value you will choose. Okay, so 22 ante 40 kgs. So the mean weight of boys is 40. Sorry, the median weight of boys is 40. The median weight of girls is also 40. What are we doing? Basically finding cumulative frequency. Once you find cumulative frequency, you will take n by 2. అండ్ ఎన్ టూ, ఎన్ బై టూ ప్లస్ వన్, ఎన్ బై టూ అబ్జర్వేషన్, దెన్ నెక్స్ట్ అబ్జర్వేషన్. ఎందుకు ఎన్ బై టూ? ఇది ఈవెన్ నెంబర్ వచ్చింది కాబట్టి, ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఈవెన్. ఓకే, సో హియర్ యూ విల్ ఫైండ్ అది ఉందా లేదా, లేదు. సో దాని నెక్స్ట్ హయ్యర్ వాల్యూకి వెళ్తారు. నెక్స్ట్ హయ్యర్ వాల్యూ 22. 17-18కి నెక్స్ట్ హయ్యర్ వాల్యూ 22. ఓకే, సో యూ విల్ చూస్ దట్ పర్టిక్యులర్ వెయిట్. క్లియర్? ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ తీసుకోరు, ఇది తీసుకుంటారు. ఈ కాలం కొత్తగా రాశారు కదా, ఇది కన్సిడర్ చేసి ఇందులోంచి వెయిట్ తీసుకుంటారు. ఓకే, ద వాల్యూ ఈ కాలంలోంచి ద వాల్యూ. సపోజ్ ఫర్ ద సేమ్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్, దీనికే దిస్ ఇస్ లెస్ దెన్ క్యూములేటివ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ వి ఫౌండ్. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు ఫైండ్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ క్యూములేటివ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ హియర్, సో వాట్ యూ డూ, యూ స్టార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్. 2 2 + 3 5, ఇజన్ ఇట్. దెన్ 5 + 5 10, 10 + 5 15, 15 + 8 23, 23 + 4 27, 27 + 3 30. సో దిస్ 30 అండ్ దిస్ 30 షుడ్ మ్యాచ్. క్లియర్? సో నౌ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డిస్కస్ షార్ట్ ఆన్సర్. సో మీడియన్ అర్థమైంది కదా, మోడ్ అంటే ఏం లేదు. సపోజ్ ఇందులోంచి మోడ్ అడిగాడు అనుకోండి, సో హయ్యెస్ట్ వాల్యూ ఏదైతే ఉంటుందో దాని కరస్పాండింగ్ ఎక్స్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ మోడ్. ఓకే, లెట్స్ డిస్కస్ ఫ్యూ షార్ట్ ఆన్సర్స్. సో అండ్ దెన్ లెట్స్ వైండ్ అప్ ద సెషన్. సో విత్ దిస్ విల్ కంప్లీట్ ఆల్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ క్వశ్చన్స్. సో రెయిన్ఫాల్ ఆఫ్ ఎ ప్లేస్ ఇస్ 4 సెంటీమీటర్, 5, 6, 12, 3, 8, 0.5. ఫైండ్ యావరేజ్ రెయిన్ఫాల్. ఆల్వేస్ రిమెంబర్ యావరేజ్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ మీన్. ఓకే, సో యూ నీడ్ టు ఫైండ్ ద యావరేజ్ రెయిన్ఫాల్. సో టు ఫైండ్ ద మీన్ వాట్ విల్ యూ డూ, యూ విల్ టేక్ ఆల్ ద సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్ డివైడెడ్ బై నంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్, దట్స్ ఇట్. సో మీన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్ డివైడెడ్ బై నంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఆర్ 4 + 5 + 6 + 12 + 3 + 8 + 0.5 డివైడెడ్ బై హౌ మెనీ ఆర్ దర్, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. యూ విల్ గెట్ ద ఆన్సర్ ఆఫ్ మీన్. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ద సేమ్ క్వశ్చన్ దే విల్ ఆస్క్ యూ టు ఫైండ్, ఇఫ్ దే ఆస్క్ యూ టు ఫైండ్ మీడియన్, హౌ విల్ యూ డూ, వాట్ విల్ యూ డూ? యూ విల్ జస్ట్ అరేంజ్ దీస్ ఇన్ ఫస్ట్ అసెండింగ్ ఆర్డర్. సో 0.5 ఇస్ ఫస్ట్, దెన్ యూ కెన్ రైట్ 3, దెన్ యూ కెన్ రైట్ 4 5 6 8 అండ్ 12. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. సో ఐ హ్యావ్ రిటన్ ఆల్. సో మీడియన్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ 2 from this side and 2 from this side. ఇఫ్ ఐ టేక్, ఐఎమ్ హ్యావింగ్ 3 values అగైన్. సో 3 from this side 3 from this side, సో ద మిడిల్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ యువర్ మీడియన్. క్లియర్? సో వెరీ ఈజీలీ యూ కెన్ ఫైండ్. సిన్స్ హియర్ ఎన్ వాల్యూ 7, ఇట్స్ అన్ ఆడ్ నంబర్, సో యూ విల్ టేక్ ఎన్ ప్లస్ 1/2 అబ్జర్వేషన్. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ 7 + 1 8/2, విచ్ ఇస్ 4th అబ్జర్వేషన్ విల్ బి యువర్ మీడియన్. 4th అబ్జర్వేషన్ ఇస్ 1 2 3 4, దిస్ ఈజ్ యువర్ మీడియన్. ఓకే, 5 ఈజ్ యువర్ మీడియన్. ఇఫ్ దే ఆస్క్ యూ మోడ్, దెర్ ఇస్ నో రిపీటెడ్ వాల్యూ, సో యూ కెనాట్ ఫైండ్ ఇట్. ఇఫ్ దే ఆస్క్ యూ మోడ్, దే విల్ గివ్ యూ రిపీటెడ్ వాల్యూ. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దే విల్ గివ్ యూ 6 and 6, సో మోడ్ ఇస్ 6. ఓకే, సో వాట్ ఎవర్ ద క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్, యూ షుడ్ బి ఏబుల్ టు డూ మీన్, మీడియన్, మోడ్ ఫర్ ద గివెన్ డేటా. ఓకే, అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇఫ్ మీన్ ఇస్ 10, మీన్ ఆఫ్ 10, 12, 18, 13, p and 17, ద అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఆర్ 10, 12, 18, 13, p and 17, మీన్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఈజ్ 15, ఫైండ్ p. ఓకే, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ దట్ మీన్ ఆఫ్ ద అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఇస్ 15. ఓకే, అండ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఆర్ వాట్, అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఆర్ 10, 12, 18, 13, p and 17. యూ నీడ్ టు ఫైండ్ దిస్ p వాల్యూ. వీ నో దట్ మీన్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ డివైడెడ్ బై నంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్. మీన్ ఈస్ గివెన్ అస్ 15, సో 15 ఈక్వల్ టు సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్ డివైడెడ్ బై నంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్. సో 15 ఇస్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ద అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ లెటెస్ట్ టేక్. సో 10 + 12 + 18 + 13 + p + 17 డివైడెడ్ బై నంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్. హౌ మెనీ ఆర్ దేర్? 1 2 3 4 5 6. యూ వాంట్ దిస్ p వాల్యూ. సో వాట్ యూ విల్ డూ, యూ జస్ట్ ట్రాన్స్పోజ్ దిస్ 6 టు ది అదర్ సైడ్. 6 ఈజ్ ఇన్ డివిజన్, సో ట్రాన్స్పోజింగ్ ఇట్ టు ది అదర్ సైడ్ యూ విల్ హ్యావ్ ఎ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ హియర్. అండ్ యాడ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్. 10 + 12 = 22, 22 + 18 = 40, 40 + 13 = 53, 53 + 17 యూఆర్ గెటింగ్ 70, అండ్ యూ హ్యావ్ p హియర్. ఓకే, నౌ వాట్ ఇస్ 15 × 6 = 90. సో 90 ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 70 + p, ఆర్ ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ p వాల్యూ ఐ షుడ్ ట్రాన్స్పోజ్ ది 70 టు ది అదర్ సైడ్. సో ఇట్ విల్ బి 90 - 70, విచ్ ఇస్ 20. సో p ఇస్ 20. డిడ్ యూ ఆల్ అండర్స్టాండ్? జస్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ రిటర్న్ మీన్ ఫార్ములా. మీన్ ఇస్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్ డివైడెడ్ బై నంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్. అండ్ యాజ్ యూ యూస్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ఇన్ 7th క్లాస్ ఆల్జీబ్రా, ఓకే, యూ జస్ట్ ట్రాన్స్పోజ్ ఇట్ టు గెట్ ద p వాల్యూ. ఓకే, కొంచెం క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ చేస్తే సింప్లిఫికేషన్ p వాల్యూ దేనికా. సేమ్ మనము ఆల్జీబ్రా ఎట్లా చేస్తుండే, లీనియర్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఎట్లా సాల్వ్ చేస్తుండే, సేమ్ థింగ్. సో ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ యూ మచ్ హియర్. నెక్స్ట్ మీడియన్. ఇఫ్ ద మీడియన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఇస్ గివెన్ అస్ 17, ఫైండ్ ఎక్స్. సీ హౌ మెనీ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. సో 3 ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ సైడ్ అండ్ 3 ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ సైడ్ వదిలేస్తే ఇదే కదా మీడియన్. And they gave you median is 17, okay? You can directly see median is nothing but which observation, since n is 7. N is 7, so median is n plus 1 by 2. So it is 8 by 2, fourth observation. Fourth observation is nothing but x. So this median is given as 17, so x is nothing but 17. It could easy only. But if they give you odd, even number of observations, because 7 is odd number, so only one value is 17. Suppose if even number of observations is there, for example, okay, look, question 7 and 10, same question I'm taking. This is your textbook question, try this question. Okay, okay, value this one. So there they asked you two values. Suppose this is the given data and say two observations are given, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now n is 8 and if they give you median of this is 17, suppose so here this observation, let me take it as x plus edana iskundam x plus 1 anukondi. Okay, so have a look here, the median is given as 17. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 observations ante you will take n by 2 observation and n by 2 plus 1 observation and you will take the average of this. 8 by 2 is 4th observation and this is 4th plus 1 is 5th observation I have to take. So 4th observation and 5th observation. Okay, the average of these two, let me do it here. So x plus 1 ante kada ee rendu add chesi divided by 2, this is nothing but 17. Median is given as 17. Okay, so x plus x is 2x plus 1 by 2 is 17. Same malli calculate cheyali, 2x plus 1 equal to 2 at pampiste 17 into 2 is 34. So 2x is 34, ee 1 at pampiste minus 1 aithe 33. So x equal to 33 divided by 2. So itla vastadi question. Okay, so మీడియన్ అంటే టూ ఆప్షన్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఐ ఫర్ ఆడ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ వాల్యూస్ అండ్ ఫర్ ఈవెన్ నెంబర్. సో ఐ ఫ్రేమ్డ్ వన్ మోర్ క్వశ్చన్ ఫర్ యూ. సో ఇఫ్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఈవెన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ వస్తే ఇట్లా మీరు ఈ టూ వాల్యూస్కి మీన్ తీసుకొని, ఓకే, యావరేజ్ తీసుకొని ఏదైతే మీడియన్ వాల్యూ ఏదైతే ఇస్తారో అది ఇక్కడ రాస్తారు అండ్ యూ విల్ సాల్వ్ ఫర్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్. క్లియర్? సో దెర్ ఇస్ వన్ మోర్ లాస్ట్ మోడల్. సో దే మే ఆస్క్ యూ టు ఫైండ్ ద మీన్ ఆఫ్ ఫస్ట్ 10 ఆడ్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్, ఫస్ట్ 10 ఈవెన్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్. సో దీస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ వేర్ ఆస్క్డ్ ప్రీవియస్ ఇయర్లో ఉన్నాయి క్వశ్చన్స్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద లాస్ట్ మోడల్, లెట్ మీ డిస్కస్ దట్ ఆల్సో అండ్ దెన్ వీ షెల్ వైండ్ అప్. సో విత్ దిస్ వీ కంప్లీటెడ్ ఆల్ ద మోడల్స్. సో నేను మీకు ఎన్ని మార్క్స్ చెప్పాను, 12 to 15 మార్క్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 40 ఆర్ ఇన్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్ నౌ. ఓకే, సో ఫైండ్ mean of first 10 odd natural numbers. ఇది మీ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్లో కూడా ఉంది క్వశ్చన్. ఫస్ట్ 10 ఆడ్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్ అంటే ఏంటి? ఆడ్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్, ఓకే, ఆడ్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్ అంటే 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19 ఇవైనా ఆడ్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్ అండ్ 10 ఉన్నాయా? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. ఓకే, సో మీన్ అంటే సమ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ అబ్జర్వేషన్స్ యూ విల్ డూ. డివైడెడ్ బై ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ అబ్జర్వేషన్. ఒకవేళ ఇవి ఈవెన్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్ అన్నారనుకోండి, అప్పుడు 2, 4, 6 సో ఆన్ ఎన్ని అడిగితే అన్ని తీసుకుంటారు. సపోజ్ 10 అడిగారంటే 10 తీసుకుంటారు. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 ఇవన్నీ యాడ్ చేసి డివైడెడ్ బై 10. ఒకవేళ ఇఫ్ దే ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ యూ మీన్ ఆఫ్ ఈవెన్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్, మీన్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ సీ హియర్ ఎన్ వాల్యూ ఇస్ 10. సో 5th అండ్ 6th అబ్జర్వేషన్ విల్ బీ యువర్ మీన్. ఓకే, సో వాట్ విల్ యూ డూ? 10 plus 12 by 2, యూ విల్ గెట్ ఇట్ యాజ్ 21 by 2, విచ్ ఇస్ 11.5 విల్ బీ యువర్ మీన్. సారీ, 10.5 విల్ బీ యువర్ మీన్. మీడియన్ కనుక్కున్నాం. మీన్ అంటే ఇట్లా, మీడియన్ అంటే ఇట్లా, ఫస్ట్ 10 ఆడ్ న్యాచురల్ నెంబర్స్ అంటే ఫస్ట్ యూ విల్ లిస్ట్ అవుట్ అండ్ దెన్ అగైన్ యూ విల్ ఫైండ్ మీన్ ఫార్ములాలో, మీడియన్ ఫార్ములాలో యూ విల్ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ అండ్ ఫైండ్. క్లియర్? సో విత్ దిస్ వీ కంప్లీటెడ్ ఆల్ ద మోడల్ క్వశ్చన్స్, నాట్ ఈవెన్ వన్ క్వశ్చన్ ఐ లెఫ్ట్. all the model questions we completed. In exam, they may just give change the numbers and give you. But all the models, okay, so they may just change the numbers and give you. So we completed the entire chapter. I did not leave even a single concept. So this session is a complete session of your statistics. I hope you like the session. I know the lighting is a problem now. Yesterday I recorded the entire chapter for you for 2 or 2.5 hours. Fine, but in record Jenika, but voice problem, mic was not working. So our video mottam waste ayipindi. Today again I started recording. Madhyalo power cut. So lot of issues I am facing, but still I tried to give you, and please adjust with the lighting. I hope you will do it. So lot of problems, I don't know why. So okay, work చేస్తున్నాం, మళ్ళీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వస్తున్నాయి, బట్ స్టిల్ వీఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఫర్ యూ. సో డూ లైక్ ద వీడియో, డూ లైక్ ద వీడియో, డూ కామెంట్ అండ్ లెట్ మీ నో హౌ ఆర్ యూ లైకింగ్ ద వీడియో. అండ్ ఆల్సో ఇఫ్ యూ విష్ టు కాంట్రిబ్యూట్ ఎనీథింగ్ టు ద ఛానల్ యూ క్యాన్ డూ ఇట్. సో స్టార్టింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ 29 rupees, 29 rupees కూడా మీరు డొనేట్ చేయొచ్చు ఛానల్కి. జాయిన్ అనే బటన్ ఉంటుంది సబ్స్క్రైబ్ పక్కన, సో యూ క్యాన్ డొనేట్ ఫ్రమ్ దేర్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్. ఇఫ్ యూ డోంట్ వాంట్ యూ క్యాన్ హ్యాపీలీ ఫాలో ద ఫ్రీ క్లాసెస్. దీస్ ఆర్ కంప్లీట్లీ ఫ్రీ. డొనేషన్ ఏంటంటే, సో మేబీ వీ కెన్ ఇంప్రూవ్ మై ఏమంటారు సెటప్ ఇంప్రూవ్ చేసి, సో ఇట్లాంటి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ని ఓవర్కమ్ చేయడానికి నాకు కొంచెం హెల్ప్ఫుల్ అవుతుంది, రైట్. సో అంతకుమించి ఇంకేం లేదు, రైట్. ఇఫ్ యూ ఫిష్ యూ క్యాన్, అదర్వైజ్ నో ప్రాబ్లమ్. బట్ డూ షేర్ ద ఛానల్ విత్ ఆల్ యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ అండ్ డూ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అండ్ డూ లైక్ అండ్ కామెంట్ అండ్ లెట్ మీ నో హౌ డిడ్ యూ లైక్ ద సెషన్. 12 to 15 marks ఆర్ యువర్స్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 40. సో ఆల్ ద వెరీ బెస్ట్ నానా, డూ వెల్ అండ్ డూ ప్రాక్టీస్ దీస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వన్స్ అగైన్. బై బై, టేక్ కేర్.